Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. On today's episode, let's look at adding footnotes and endnotes to Pages documents. So let's start by adding a simple footnote to a Pages document. Now, a footnote is going to be a reference in the text that will then have a note at the bottom of the current page. So you can easily add one by going to Insert, Footnote. And you may think what you need to do first is select the text that you want to have the footnote reference. But if you do that, it's going to actually replace the text with the footnote. You want to put the cursor at the spot where you want the footnote to be. So if I'm going to put it right there, I can then go Insert Footnote. I'll jump to the bottom of the page and I'll see footnote number one, and I can add my text. And if I look where I added it, I can see that number one appears there next to the text. So let's add another one. I'll put that one right there and I'll do Insert Footnote. And I'll type something. Now if I were to actually insert a lot of text here, it would expand the bottom here as needed to add as many footnotes, as many lines as are needed. So I've got footnote number one there. I've got footnote number two here. Now if you don't like the style here, you can change it, but that's separate from the footnote functionality. So for instance, I'll select this one here and let's make it bold. Let's increase the point size by one and let's make it a different color. And that's great, but it only changes this one here. However, I can set a character style. So I'll click Character Styles here, add a new one, and I'll call this footnote number. And then I'll select the second footnote here and I will set that as well. So if I were to set a third footnote right there, and go back to here, I would have to manually set this, but it's pretty easy because I've got the footnote number there. And if I wanted to change this, say, oh, I want to make it a different color, I want to make it a green there, it won't change it here unless I go in to Character Styles and say update that style. And now it updates all those. So I get to customize how the footnotes look if I want by combining footnotes with character styles. Now the footnotes themselves down here, when you select them, they've got their own styles as well. So I can select in the text here. If I go to Format Text, I can see that the style is set to footnote, and I could update that if I were to change it here, make it bold for instance, then I would have an update button and it would update everything. So I do have the chance to do that. Also notice when I select footnotes, in addition to Format Text, I have Format Footnotes. I have a few options I can choose here. One is I can use different numbering schemes. I can also decide whether I want the numbering to be continuous, so if I had another footnote three pages after this it would be number four. Or I can say every page starts with number one, or I can do it by section as well. And I can add some spacing between the notes. So I have some control over how the footnotes actually appear on the page. Now you actually have two different types of footnotes. One are footnotes, the other are endnotes. And the difference is that endnotes appear at the end of the document instead of at the bottom of every page. Now you can only use one or the other in a Pages document. So now that I've actually created some footnotes, it's set as footnotes and I can't insert an endnote is what they're called. But I can actually go in here and go to Format Footnotes and switch to Document Endnotes or Section Endnotes. So Document Endnotes would actually get rid of it there, and if I go all the way to the bottom of the document there will be a new page where it actually has all of the footnotes. And now if I go to add another one like here, actually let's do it right here, I'll insert and I can do Document Endnote. See, footnote changed to that. Notice when I do that it inserted it between the second and third one, moving the third one down to the fourth. So you don't have to worry about manually numbering these, whether they're footnotes or endnotes. It will work either way. If you want to delete a footnote or endnote, you can basically just select the actual note right there and hit the delete key. And that will actually renumber them. So you can see that the second note here, which I didn't style originally, that was the third one. It got changed to number two, and the fourth one got changed to number three, and the note is now missing. It's an end note, and it's missing here from the end. Also, you can, from footnotes or endnotes, you can easily jump to them if you want to see where this one is. The trick is to double click on the number. And now when you do that, the cursor is now at that location, but it's not going to take the page there. But if I just use the forward or backward arrow key, it will quickly jump to where I've been. So you can do that very easily by just double clicking on the number at the footnote or endnote and using the arrow keys.